It's going to be a scorcher today, and I'm off to the beach in my swanky electric car that's eco-friendly, range of 260 miles, except the beach is 280 miles round trip, and I want to get there and back for free. That's the plan anyway. I mean, what could possibly go wrong? Range anxiety, you have to stop to charge for hours, it costs you loads of money, all things you hear in the same sentence as long distance and electric cars. My challenge today is to disprove that and show that you can travel a long distance, it not costs you a lot, and it doesn't delay your journey that much either. No scientific experiment would be complete without a stopwatch, so I have one here. Apple Maps says it's going to take 2 hours 28 minutes to get there, and that's with no stops whatsoever. So we'll start the stopwatch, see what the difference is when we arrive down in Bournemouth. So, 3, 2, 1, go! Whilst I'm driving, I'll put some data on the screen so you can see what the outside air temperature's like, what my aircon was set to, stuff like that, so you can compare your driving style to mine, so you can kind of gauge what range you might get. So I did my research before I bought this car, and it charges quick. The battery is about 50 kilowatts, or 50,000 watts. To put that into context, a kettle uses about 3 kilowatts per hour, but obviously you only boil it for about 5 minutes, so it's not an issue. Some Tesla superchargers will charge as high as 250 kilowatts an hour, and although you don't generally get 250 kilowatts, which I'll explain in another video, even at half that you're looking at 30 minutes from flat to fully charged, except you don't arrive there flat, and you don't leave there fully charged. So every stop is going to take you under 30 minutes to get your battery back up to where it should be. So I challenge you, next time you're at the services, time yourself how long it takes you to leave the car, go to the services and come back. I did this before I bought the car and it took me over 25 minutes if I was getting food. And even if I was just using the toilets, it still took 15 minutes. And we're talking number ones here, not number twos. Now, I don't know whether that's fast or slow, because weirdly, none of my friends wanted to time themselves going into the services. I mean, what is their problem? So if you have done it, let me know in the comments below, because I'm intrigued to find out whether I'm quick or slow. But either way, if I'm about on average, 25 minutes is going to see you through a charge without a problem. So therefore, it's not going to add any time onto your journey. Anyway, enough about my toilet habits. What I'm trying to say is you're likely to stop on a long journey, and that stop is going to be long enough for you to get enough charge to move on to your next destination. Or that's what I'm hoping to prove today. Okay, on to how I'm planning to do it for free. I've got solar panels on my roof and a smart charger that channels all the excess energy into my car to charge it, so I don't end up paying for electricity and use all the solar energy I produce. Where that might not pay off today though is the sun didn't shine as much as I'd hoped yesterday, so I've only set off with 74% charge. But the Tesla predicts how much energy you'll have when you get to your destination, and it's currently saying when I get to the Winchester supercharger I'll have 26%. Normally it underestimates things, so I'm quite confident I'm going to make it there without any problems. So I'll do that part of the journey purely on my solar energy. But they charge for superchargers, I hear you say, and you'd be right. However, Tesla often do promotions. If you're buying a Tesla, use my referral code, because then we both get 1,000 free miles on the superchargers. Win-win! Now, on the supercharger network, if you do have to pay, it's 24p per kilowatt, which is a little bit more expensive than your home electricity, because it is generally about 15p per kilowatt at home. Or if you're on the right electricity tariff, it could be as little as 5p. There are actually some electricity companies out there that will pay you to use electricity at the right times. And yes, you did hear me right, they pay you to use electricity. If you're interested in finding out more about that, I'm doing a video on electricity tariffs shortly. I know, thrilling content on this channel, but if you don't want to miss that, click subscribe and notifications on, and when that gets uploaded, you can learn all about electricity tariffs. So anyway, back to superchargers. Let's say worst case scenario, you have to pay 24p per kilowatt. An electric car generally does between 3 to 4 miles per kilowatt, depending on whether it's summer or winter. More in summer, less in winter. I'm hoping to get 4 miles per kilowatt today, but I'll update you at the end of the video what I actually achieved. So you take your 24p per kilowatt, divide that by 4, that gets you a cost of about 6p per mile. Now, if you were to be driving a 60 mpg petrol or diesel car, that would cost you about 12p per mile, so you've already halved it. But a lot of cars are less fuel efficient than that. So electric cars should be cheap to drive long distance and not massively delay your journey. That's the theory anyway. I will update you in about an hour's time to see how it's going. over an hour has passed. We've got 45% on the battery and anticipate having 36% when we get there, which is way better than it actually originally predicted. It was 26% when we left. What you find with the predictions is they're accurate. If anything, they overestimate how much charge you'll use. So you always end up getting there with more charge than it originally said, which I'd rather it obviously do, because then you won't run out of charge. Range anxiety isn't really a thing at the minute. My biggest anxiety is my bladder, because I really need to stop soon and we've still got about 40 minutes till the charger. So here we go, my hopefully one and only stop on the way down to Bournemouth. I've not had to deviate much from my route either, because the bonus of Tesla superchargers is they're generally well placed throughout the road network. The navigation system is also well integrated into the car, so it will route you to a supercharger if it knows you won't get to the destination with enough charge. You can actually see if the supercharger is being used or not, and whether anyone is on it. Now, it did say someone was using it, and that would be right. So far so good. So I knew there would be one space available, and that turns out to be the case. So I will pull up now and we will get charging, and I'm going to pop straight in and use the facilities. That's charge complete, enough to get me to Bournemouth and back to this charger later on. Maybe took me a little bit longer than I would have taken normally, because you can see I just had a sandwich rather than going to a takeaway and a services. But it was a lovely day and I didn't mind sitting out there in the sun, having a drink, having a sandwich, and just waiting for my car to charge a little bit longer. We went from 35% up to 88% in about 25 minutes. And that's bearing in mind that there was another vehicle using the charger, and that was one of the version 1 chargers, which only goes up to 130 kilowatts. And now if there's two cars using these lower version chargers at the same time, it spreads the charge between the two cars, so it's 130 divided by 2. So it was a little bit slower than you'd normally anticipate. The newer chargers, the 250 kilowatt ones, don't actually share that charge. So they are definitely a lot quicker. So that should be enough to get me from here to Bournemouth and back and leave my car in sentry mode all day. Now, if you don't know what sentry mode is, it's a security system that uses all the cameras around the car to record any abnormal behavior while you're away. But it does use a little bit of the battery, not massively, but it is something you need to anticipate if you're gonna leave it on all day. So I'm expecting all day in Bournemouth that will use between 5 and 10% maybe. But that charge was absolutely easy, and now I am beach bound to get some tannage in. We're about to arrive at Bournemouth, and the journey time has completely gone out the window. It was meant to be 2 hours 28 minutes, but I've hit heavy traffic. Yeah, it's taken way, way longer than it should have, but not because of the charging or the fact I've been driving an electric car. So we'll have to go for the time that we stopped at the charger, which was 25 minutes, plus what would have been the normal journey time. As I've already discussed though, I'd have stopped for at least 15 minutes for a toilet break anyway, so we're talking probably 10 minutes extra to get down here, excluding the traffic. The charge is going to be about 70% when we get there. Now weirdly, because of the traffic, it's actually made the charge better than what it should have done. That's the thing with electric cars, you find in traffic or slower speeds, they hold their charge better, whereas high speed motorway driving, where you don't get any regen, you actually use more charge. I did say how many miles per kilowatt we were going to achieve on the way down here, and my target was 4. So don't forget, that would have worked out as about 6p per mile on a supercharger. I'm actually at 192 watts per mile, which is just over 5 miles per kilowatt, which at supercharger rates means that will cost me less than 5p per mile. And if I was charging off of my home charger overnight, then that would cost me less than a penny a mile at the 5p per kilowatt rate. Bargain. So I'm almost at the beach now, and I'm gonna park up, leave the car with sentry mode on all day, and then go and tan. And I'll update you when I come back as to how much charge it's used. And then we'll do some brief filming on the way home, just so you can see how I get on the trip back. But I'm hoping for less traffic, because this is not what I can for today. We'll be right back. my day at the beach done. Hopefully I'm more tanned than when you saw me earlier. I'm definitely sandier and greasier. Sentry mode's been on all day. It's been on 6 hours and drained the battery by 6%. So let's find out how long it's going to take us to get to the Winchester Supercharger, our one and only stop on the way home. Just calculating the route now, and it's saying we will have 32% battery when we get there, and we've currently got 59%. So it should take us an hour and 20 minutes. Fingers crossed the traffic is okay. I've reset the trip meter for the way back on a separate one, so we'll get an overall, and then this journey back, so hopefully there will be no traffic, so we'll get a more realistic view of watts per mile and how many miles per kilowatt you can come to expect. I'm not going to do much filming on the way back because you've seen it all before, and I'll see you again at the Supercharger and update you when we get there. That stop took about 14 minutes and went from 36 to 70%. Now I'm not going to charge all the way up because I don't need it, and I'll charge with my solar panels tomorrow. As long as it gets me home with more than 20%, that should do me fine, which it's predicting it should be. It's good practice to keep it above 20% as that keeps longevity in the battery. Now, before I set off home, I think I'm going to have to shoot this last bit because it's 9:45 at night and I'm fast losing the light. When I get home, I will have driven 280 miles and it will not have cost me a penny thanks to free supercharger miles, which don't forget to use my referral code if you do buy a Tesla, and then you'll get 1,000 free super miles as well. It's probably delayed me, well, I was going to say 25 minutes, but actually it's probably 10 minutes because each stop would have been 15 minutes anyway for the toilet. This stop here was less than 15 minutes anyway, and then the other stop was 25 minutes. So I'd say, all in all, 10 minutes delay in total. The thing that delayed me the most today was the traffic in the UK, but it also did mean I didn't use as much charge, so that was quite good. So for a 10 minute delay for 6 hours driving and the cost saving, I don't think that's a bad deal. Considering that if I'd have done that in a car, that journey would have cost me anything between £30 or £60. So mission accomplished. Range anxiety is a thing of the past and much cheaper to drive electric, whether you've got a referral code or not. That's it, because it's getting very dark and I need to get home. So don't forget to subscribe, and then you'll get lots more videos about the Living with Tesla series. And also turn notifications on and you'll get notified when I upload some videos. If you've got any questions or comments, please feel free to add them below and I'll do my best to respond. Right, homeward bound.